Hi everybody, I'm so happy to see you all. Sorry I haven't done that many videos lately, but I'm gonna make these two videos. I hope you will enjoy them. It's gonna be about my origami collection. As many of you know, it used to be a huge hobby of mine, like a passion of mine, to do origami and all different types of them. I used to do just a regular origami, then 3D origami, then kusudamas, and kirigami. So, I'll put the names down below and I'll show you some examples of each. In this video, I'm gonna go through this book, which is sort of my supply book, simply because it makes really nice sounds, and I'm really crazy about those. So we'll go through that one. And in the next video, in the second one, I'll show you the actual kusudamas and the objects that I actually made. So I hope you stay tuned and I hope you will enjoy this. Sorry about the weird angle. I was trying different ways and this one seemed to be the best one. So, this is sort of my supply book. It's pretty big, but I really like it because it has a lot of smooth textures. How wonderfully this color matches my nails. Some nice lilacs, some oranges. I really like the quality of the file holders. This plastic file holders. I have some yellows. Some greens. And the most nice part about this is I like files. I like everything organized and clean cut and put well together. And I like small surfaces as well. I just like this one because it's sort of like glass, glossy kind of a surface, and that drives me crazy in a good way because it's so, I don't know, so smooth, like ice or like surface of water untouched, and it's very nice. I like binders and organization things. And this is a nice, is it fuchsia color, I think. Very nice. Then I have these pastel colors in a yellow and a pink. Have some pre-cut ones. Now, this is just a page with some missing pieces from kusudama that I started about a year ago, but I never finished it. And I will show you that one. It just has some missing parts, some missing pieces from it. It's just a couple, so I really just need to take my time and finish it up. If any of you follow me long enough, you will remember that in one of my early videos, I showed this one. Kusudama, and it's missing just a few pieces, which are these. So when I have time, I'm hoping to try and finish that one up. Also, I have some plans for the future. So right here you can see I have some stars designs and some like, well, stars. Then underneath I have some diagrams and instructions of how to make those. Those are in my plans as well. Then I have a plan to do this merengue type, which is not very close. I cannot really show it too closely. But it's like a puffed up type of origami where it's the way it's mended, it looks like it's been inflated a little bit in parts. And so, by the way, I have printed these out and actually made all of my kusudamas with the help of instructions by Miss Ekaterina Lukashova, who is, I believe, is a Russian person. And if you go to her website, which is kusudama.me, and you can follow her links to YouTube, to instructional videos or just diagrams. And I think she's really good at those. And I have followed all of her instructional videos, and it's just wonderful. So I have to give her credit for that. Then this one's a Bella, which is, it has been made by me, and I will show you that one in my next video. And then I have some little silly drawings of things, and some of the things that I just keep organized in this folder now. They used to be in my at my work, in the folder that's called Creation Inspiration Folder. Just kind of tacky, but at the same time, it's just some of the things that I would draw or come up with at work. So I used to keep that. I no longer do, unfortunately. It's just some random things. This is just nice squishy sounds. Paper or something. I just really like to squeeze it, like pressing it, because it makes a funny sound. Like, I don't know, like it. I'm weird. Then I have some of the 3D origami samples. If you look closer, I don't think you can see it well. And basically, this one is one of my favorites, and I'm hoping to make this one sometime. It's sort of made in a round shape, but it's done in a rainbow pattern, so it changes color like this, circle by circle by circle, and it has these pointy parts. It's like a bowl, let's say. You cannot actually use it as a bowl. It's just not sturdy enough, but when I finish it, I don't know, when I would start it, I'm hoping that it will turn out well. Then I have this vase, which is also one of my hopes for the future to make, but so far, nothing. So far I have you guys to spend my time with. Then, let's start with the pop-up art, or it's called actually kirigami. That is an art of bending and cutting out paper from paper. Basically, you do sort of 3D models out of paper. I'll show you. So, for example, you can see how on this page here, you can see how parts, some of the parts are cut out, and some of the parts are just popping out, sort of like forwarded forward. And it's basically just one piece of paper, and you cut out some parts and fold the others, which I'm just repeating myself, but it creates this sort of a shape, which is really nice. Like, something funny also, or interesting to make. I like pyramids with people there. It makes it look very, very neat. I think you can show it off to your friends. I don't think everybody, well, not many people make these. So then you can do like architectural buildings with openings and some cutouts with some stairs, some like walls. So it actually looks like an actual architectural sculpture or something. But at the same time, it's just one piece of paper. you can also do cards, like cards for your friends. You can put their names. Like here, for example, we have a name Ryan. And you see some parts cut out completely, some are just popping out. And I think it's very nice and neat touch. It's a personal touch, definitely. If you make it yourself, I'm pretty sure your friend or your family would love that. If you do like your something like best dad or best mom, something cheesy like that, but it could be really nice and interesting. Or if a name of your loved one, you can make it in different colors. You can put different backgrounds behind these letters, and it will sort of create an illusion of a 3D name popping out. And if you make it yourself, that makes the gift just that much more appreciated and that much more personal. So this is an example of how to make it before you cut out. This is how it would look like in the beginning. So once again, these are just structural sort of 3D models, like that. So I'll just put these to the side and I will show you what I have made. These are not as exciting as the ones that I just showed you. Once again, because I'm pretty immature at these, and I just started making them, so please forgive me. Okay, so this is one of them, which is kind of like a pyramid. And we are going to count the stairs, or how many layers it has. Let's start with the first one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 6 layers. Then you need to close it down this way. Just fold it flat. Try to keep it under some kind of heavy object, so it keeps it. I'm going to show you this one, but I'm not proud of it because I messed it up. You can tell by the stairs. I'm actually going to close it down because I'm pretty ashamed of this one. So, this is the next one, which is kind of neat, I think. It's just some flights of stairs. It does create a sort of a 3D illusion, in my opinion, the best. And it's just a couple of flights of stairs that go from the top down, from the top down, and then again down and lower and down. You want to count the stairs? Also a pyramid. Looks like this. I think it also looks kind of neat. It's not that clean cut, but still, I'm pretty proud of these. Because I tried to make them and they were so interesting to make. So that's another one. I have another one which is like this. Also the stairs. And guess what? We're gonna count them too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just going up and down and lower and lower. Just going down. Them down. First to the side. Now the last one. It's sort of like a little city. Which I messed up the stairs all over here, but still. I think it still looks pretty nice and neat. This is what it looks like from the back. You can just put these on your table or something and show them off. I will put a description of this art, which is called 3D pop-up art, or kirigami, down below, so you can check it out if you're interested. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.